Las Vegas, Nevada, the self-styled capital of show business, with the emphasis very much on business. The Desert Inn is one of the city's most prestigious hotels, but it is feeling the financial pinch. To attract the guests and gamblers that keep the hotel and casino profitable, the Desert Inn depends upon the increasingly expensive stars in its theater. While the tourists relax, the hotel president must struggle to maintain this delicate financial balance. In the television series Vegas, the president is played by Burton Cohen. In real life, the president is Burton Cohen.
The star policy worked, but unfortunately, we were faced with a situation where the shortages of stars that could fill a showroom was creating a situation where their prices were going up and the lack of availability. It's almost like a good soccer player. That is a talent. It's very much in demand, and the price for that particular player goes up.
The YWCA, London. Burton Cohen plans to stage a long-running review. He's in London to audition an English contingent of dancers. Preparing the audition is Dick Price, who will produce the review.
You know, see who they like and if they want you to do some more, teach you some more.
The lure of Las Vegas ensures a large turnout, but quantity does not necessarily ensure the qualities that the producer is looking for.
I have to figure what they will be like made up, and I'm going to go through this very quickly, I have a feeling. I can tell I'm tight, no, much too heavy in the thigh. The only one in there that's interesting is the redhead.
That's the only one. Yes.
Thank you. All right, will you excuse these ladies, and then I'll teach them all the other combination, because we have to get on with it,
okay? Yeah, you don't want them to wait.
A review can be expensive to produce, but it should be cheap to maintain. So if Burton Cohen's experiment is to succeed, it must last. The contracts on offer are for 15 months at £160 a week. For some of the dancers, it's too long and too little. In the end, only two girls were considered good enough and prepared to sign the contract, Geraldine Goff and Jane Ann Lowes. Geraldine is 22. Born and brought up in Dublin, she has recently given up her ambition and training as a dress designer to devote herself entirely to dance. Jane Ann, 21, from South London, gained her equity membership working at Butlin's, so Las Vegas has an obvious appeal. Two boys were also chosen. Peter Simon, who has given up a summer season to see Las Vegas, and John Sullivan, though a veteran of 35, he has never worked in America before. Paris. After further auditions, a multinational cast was assembled. The review is to be based on New Year's Eve at a Paris nightclub, the Alcazar. After 4 weeks' rehearsal in France, the dancers fly off for their first glimpse of America.
Can we dress up?
It is. Sure.
Right, so
the wedding one.
Can we have the shotgun wedding photo?
I could, sure.
The shootout wedding.
You want to put a gun to us out?
Yes.
Okay.
It's now or never.
I could be a cowboy.
I've already had one man today. I may as well shoot another.
You have
a
choice
over here. Yeah?
Okay. Oh,
great wedding dress.
Sure. It's
wonderful.
Pick anyone you like.
That's nice.
Which
jeweled and all.
Like?
That's nice.
Jeweled one is different.
Oh, look, isn't this too much? John, you'll never see me like this again.
What? Anything for me, is there?
Oh, gosh, this wonderful moment.
What are you going to wear?
I don't know, you haven't decided.
Put the giggle band on. You know why it's a giggle band? Because once you get past that, you're laughing.
It's only a water pistol, but it looks authentic in the picture. And when I take a picture, I want you to look up and look smug, and you look really worried, okay?
Worried.
So the first 10 don't move, okay?
Yeah.
Step in just a little.
John,
Tubby had to worry.
Sorry, yeah. Yeah.
Great, hold up.
Wow. What have you done?
Oh, God.
It looks like Lena Martell. Yes, come on.
Now then.
What about a head? Has she no headband or anything?
Not that one, Jane. Looks like a dead cat.
Terrible. I've got it. John, I've got it.
Love it. Love it.
You've got the axe.
Peter, come on.
Peter.
You will be axe now, strangle you.
Oh, that's great.
Jane, you used the axe.
My
God! Time for sightseeing is limited. For Peter, Jane Ann, Geraldine and John, the costumes of the Old West hardly prepare them for the harsh realities of the New West that they're about to encounter. The Alcazar show must open as soon as possible. The Desert Inn certainly cannot afford an empty theatre. As the cast arrive at the Desert Inn, they prepare for a new experience. Although John and Peter will mostly be employed as fake French waiters wandering around the auditorium whipping up enthusiasm, most of the girls will have some scenes individually tailored to their talents. Now they must prepare to give their audience the next best thing to New Year in Paris. This is the culmination of months of planning and preparation, weeks of rehearsal, and for the dancers, two rather disorientating days in Las Vegas.
Yeah, it's tremendous. I mean, it looked great. Vegas was just what we imagined. The strip was all lit up, and we were just totally spaced out in the whole thing.
I was frightened, really. This strip was just incredible. The lights, everything. I mean, I was frightened being 20 on my own in Vegas. It was just frightening for me.
Can you do the top?
Mm-hmm.
Joey.
If the Alcazar show is a new experience for the dancers, it's still more so for the Desert Inn. Producer Dick Price fears that not everyone shares Burton Cohen's enthusiasm for the project.
The feeling that I had in dealing with the technique, the technical people, or the stagehands, as you would say here, it's very heavily unionized here in the United States. And they, I don't feel that, I didn't feel then that they were terribly thrilled about having a production show. They have had over a period of years, they had production shows here many years ago, which were quite successful. Then they went into a star policy, which was big name stars. The stars here treat them very well. They get an awful lot of money under the table for doing special favors and things like that. This sort of an attitude was what I was confronted with. It was impregnated in the backstage personnel who didn't particularly want the show in the first place. That's the feeling that I had.
Montmartre, where in the old days they really knew how to celebrate. So let's go back to 1890 and start things off with the original French cancan.
Thank you.
The next day's papers bring the reviews. They are not positive.
Well, it's the only negative review I've written in the last 2.5 years. The show was kind of amateurishly put together. The sound was on tape. It was an insult to the people in Las Vegas and to the people showgoers. It didn't come up anywhere near to the standard of a good lounge show.
Back at the Desert Inn, explanations abound for this lack of critical success.
The majority of the reviewers that came in to see this show didn't understand what we were trying to do. So they came in with a preconceived notion that the Desert Inn was going to outproduce and outproduction Hallelujah Hollywood and the Lido show. As you know, there are no magicians, there are no jugglers, there are no animals on stage. This show just moves for an hour and 35 minutes of pure, solid entertainment.
I mean, I've had my antenna out, why and what for. For one thing, the local press makes the gossip columnist or the columnist or the critiques are the people who write about the stars. If you don't have stars, what do you write about? You have a show that comes in, which is a production show. What's exciting about that? It opens, you review it, and then it runs. But if you have a new star every 2 weeks, you've got something to interview, something to write a critique about.
That was mentioned as one of the reasons. That isn't the main reason. The main reason is the show. If the show were excellent, that would not be a factor. But it has to be excellent, and it just isn't.
But the show must go on, despite deepening doubts. Dancers are not paid to react, but under the harsh spotlight of adverse criticism, it's not always easy to maintain your enthusiasm.
It really isn't working. And it's worse because we're on stage, we've got egg on our faces. We're the ones they're looking at. Production. There's no money involved. They haven't put enough in. Don Arden of MGM is putting 10 million into his new show. Burton's put 1 million.
And I learnt my first American word through it. Turkey. It's a turkey.
Oh, dear.
And that's what they call it, a turkey. Even the whole of Vegas was calling it after 4 days a turkey. And it'll last 5 days.
They know Vegas. I don't know what goes well here. I mean, I just took their word for it when they said the show would do well here. I said, well, that's what the American people like. Well, I don't know American people.
I feel they didn't put enough research into the actual show, coming to that actual room. The show, as it was in Paris, worked fine for the room where it was. But the room here is much bigger, stage is much bigger, mm-hmm. and you're working to a much bigger audience, so you're losing the intimacy of the original production, which was in Paris, and has been a success there for about 10 years.
Disaster follows disaster. A mysterious accident on stage results in Peter Hayner, friend of the producer and the show's leading man, falling and breaking his wrist. Dick Price must take his place, so Peter gives Geraldine a last-minute rehearsal before she takes to the stage with her new partner.
One, two, three. It's more.
The dancers are not slow to assess the implications of small audiences and sporadic applause.
It's all politics, to which we are a very, very small part. With international stars involved, with big businessmen involved, it's in my case, I look at it like this, it's sort of moving people. It's a moving people game. Our show is not a success, and it needs to be a success to draw people in, get them into this theatre, get them out into the casino. And when this doesn't, when we become a liability, then everybody's threatened. The stars, because they're not in the room anymore, so they're not paying them.
There's nowhere to play for them now, you see.
So the big companies, because they're losing money, because they're not coming, they lose money anyway on the shows, but they're losing a lot more on the casinos because the people out there. And thirdly, the man that produced the show is in trouble because we have got, as I said before, a turkey. And it's affected us all, hasn't it? Really.
This is supposed to be the capital of show business. Supposed to be. I'll tell you, I'm really astounded. As far as that's concerned, they're all money talks here. That's the only thing. Money talks.
What happened here was a groundswell that started out long before this show came into town, in which some of the entertainers that had played here took offense that another showroom was disappearing, in which they no longer could get their $125,000 and $150,000 a week. So they didn't take too kindly to this show.
Most vocal amongst the show's celebrity critics is Wayne Newton.
My reaction to the Alcazar show has nothing to do at all with the show. Here you have the president of that hotel, a general manager for all practical purposes. Okay? Now his job encompasses many things. It would frankly not be unlike a general for an army, you know. He doesn't have to go out and dig the little trains himself, you know. He has to be able to delegate that authority to someone. This man who runs the Desert Inn decided that he was an entertainment producer. Every headliner that has been in that place, he has alienated, including myself. Every one of us swore that we would never go back and never have.
Backstage, there's a little area in which the kids or the technique can sit. It's a sort of a little conversation room where they can have coffee and things like that. And there's a wall with pictures of the different stars that have played here. Anthony Newley, Juliet Prowse, people like that, with a picture of them and a star, and then they write a little something, you know, a sort of a autograph wall. Well, one of them had written up on the wall, it has since been covered over, one of them, Mr. Wayne Newton, had written on the wall, Cohen and that dog he just rode in on. I shall return, Wayne, the chief.
You know, my resentment of his act has nothing at all to do with the show. You know, it's a very personal feeling. And I totally agree with his right to do it. I just don't agree with the fact that he did it.
But Wayne Newton is not alone in his criticism of Mr. Cohen's experiment.
I think that's an interesting case because the man who, in fact, runs the hotel felt, rightly or wrongly, that he was paying far too much for the likes of performers like this, and that he could probably, if he got a show that had pizzazz and girls and that, he could probably make more money by paying them smaller cash and getting a bigger return. Unfortunately, I don't think it works that way because he brought a small French show to a town where if you're going to do a French show, you give it the lot. I mean, there's 8,000 girls come out, things coming out of the ceiling, Roy and his German boyfriend killing tigers. I mean, the whole thing's going on. You can't bring a cute little French show to this town. They're not interested. They either want to see that big French show or they want to see performers. And I think that's where he was misguided. And all the things I've heard about the Alcazar show is that it's a pint pot stuck into a quart jug. And I think that's where he's made his mistake. And as a performer, I have great sympathy for those performers, because that's no fun to play to poor houses. I, in my time, have played to an empty house, so I know, you know, I know what that feels like. But I think the man was ill-advised. And I think the whole town thinks he was ill-advised, but he has enormous pride and he's going to keep on biting the bullet.
Well, he wanted to buck the trend of the proliferation of salaries, and he thought this was the way to do it. And obviously it isn't.
Will that in effect cost him money?
It may cost him more than that.
But we are in the people moving business. We have these shows to move as many people as we can through our casino. So if it gets to the point of declining balances, then I might have to make a decision that it's not doing the job and start looking for other vehicles that could do the job.
Deborah, star! Big smile, darling, don't be afraid. That's it, yes. They don't bite, my God, she's got her tap shoes on.
Although the dancers have signed a 15-month contract, only one side is binding. If the show closes, they will lose their jobs. So the less enthusiastic the audience, the more enthusiastic must be their performance.
I love to sit and hear him dream. He tells it like a story. He talks about a better time, happy days and glory. No more scratching, more
With their jobs in jeopardy, some of the cast decide to seek other work in the city. At the MGM Grand Hotel, Don Arden is auditioning for a new spectacular.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Okay.
So this step right here. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Rock. 5, 6, 7, 8. Deborah Starr, may I see you?
Okay, so we walk forward.
Look, I'm going to have to ask you, please, get dressed now. Go back, get your contract, bring it to me. I've asked the other kids to do that too. I don't want to cause any problems to Alcazar.
Yeah.
You want some water?
You know that I want you.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
I want you here if legally I can do it.
Okay.
We don't want
out.
But Burton Cohen still stoutly maintains that his venture has not yet failed.
We do not like to underwrite something that is not successful. But you must remember this, that what I'm comparing the attendance against was the cost of what I had before. With everybody that I would put into the showroom, I would wind up losing anywhere from $5 a head to $27 a head, depending upon the cost of that particular star attraction. So we were suffering a loss in the showroom of about $3 million a year, which is all right, providing the showroom is full, because we're in the casino business and not in the entertainment business. It's not necessary for my showroom to show a profit similar to what the Palladium must do in London.
One Pepsi.
That's fine.
So when did you start in gym?
Do you think they'll get out of this the contract then? Charlie?
Yeah. Bernard told me himself, he said, you're not happy here, I'll let you out of the contract, because if you're not happy, you'll bitch and moan about everything.
But after
and
three...
he doesn't want to be bothered, and you don't want to be bothered, so he'd just rather let you go.
But there's nine of them.
After 3 months, they can't hold us.
Sure they can. Yeah, they can. There's sure. Always ways to get out of the contract.
First of all...
And Don Arden's helping
us. In this country, there's no way that you can...
That's slavery.
Jane, look, Jane, this
one. I know, but by the time they left it, we could have closed.
Go on, Patrick.
Come on.
Yeah. And what happens when they leave, the nine people?
We'll have to hire new people. All we'll have to do is call equity.
But while the show is still running, Burton Cohen is not going to release anyone from their contractual obligations.
Well, then we got the president of the Desert Inn to come down and chat to us and get us all together and talk to us. In which he sat down and just really told us that he was in charge and he was the boss.
And no nobody way would, can we leave. No
nobody
way.
Would step out of line as long as he was in charge.
It's just scare tactics.
If you leave, they will take legal action and try and...
And they will find you all over the world.
Wherever you are in the world.
Wherever you are.
That's practically what he's saying to us.
We will pin you down.
And we will take legal action.
And he said that if anybody has any ideas of getting out of their contract... No way. Not a chance.
It was just a question of, like Charlie, he said, I hate it here. Please let me out. Burton just turned and said, tough shit. You've signed that contract.
You're on use. You're here
you're
to stay
here, and that's it.
Oh, he made it very clear, you know, that he was going to hold us to it. And he said, you're not slaves. I can't force you to work. But he said, if you leave, I'll sue.
But he has a little bit of power in this town. It was one of those little undertones.
Yes, that we never swipe people from different shows, that you'll never be able to work in another show.
Because if I don't want you to work in this town, you won't work in this town.
With the employment issues settled, certain changes can now be made to give the show a more traditional Las Vegas appeal. Jane Anne discovers that her contract stipulates topless work if necessary.
It's that's the town mean. Full of tits and arse. That's what they want. Tits, feathers and arses.
Thank you.
de même. Pourquoi je t'aime, toi qui te moques de moi et de tout, avec ton air.
Predictably, audience interest increases, and for the first time since the show opened, the dancers have a chance to relax.
I might overcome the anger that I've learned to know. Find a peace of mind I lost so long ago. Your gentle touch has made me strong again.
Hi, Gary.
Come on, I've got money in me pocket.
Give me the key to the apartment, Jan. $10 for Burton Coyne.
I love two ghosts swimming.
American money doesn't deteriorate in water, it washes right. Wonderfully.
Yes, but the pound's floating.
Now, what are we going to do with
you? If you go, you must take her with you.
No.
I think you're
right. No!
Yes!
Yes! Don't leave!
Yes, yes, do it, do it.
No!
Do it.
No! 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 No!
Wait. Wait. Daphne! Deborah! Come.
Jan!
I'm gonna go home. If you got
oh,
any...
come have some wine with us.
Oh, God, no.
Oh, it'll be wonderful.
All right.
That's a lovely idea.
Our show is now running. It is successful. The people are coming. It's they leave satisfied and happy, and that is what it's about. Gentlemen, and we hope to see you soon again.
Where's that?
At the
Alcazar de Paris.
This city is very special. It's not New York, it's not London, it's not Paris. And it's not Berlin. It's very special, and it has its own rules, its own what will go and what will not go, apparently. I just learned. We thought we were going to have the most sensational show in Las Vegas. I still think we are. I still think we do. As a matter of fact, it's happening now. It's going to work. It is working.
What the hell,
the holy gully? Look,
Pam? Pam? Did you speak to Bernard?
No, no, I haven't. You
that's why you're using it. What's wrong, man?
Sorry?
Do I have to clean that one?
As the revamped Alcazar show settles into the Desert Inn, so Jane Anne and Geraldine can settle into the inverted lifestyle of the Las Vegas dancer, living and working by night and sleeping by day.
Can't help it, dear.
I know, you love it so
I have
much.
More things to do than others.
Now listen here, Mary.
Two months later, contractors are changing the signs in front of the Desert Inn. The Alcazar's improvements proved insufficient, and Burton Cohen has decided to close the show.
Well, it was a difficult decision to make. The show on closing is 100 times better than the show that we opened up, but we're in the people moving business. And unless we can fill that showroom twice a night, then it defeats the purpose of the show. And we thought that we could overcome some of the problems that we had initially. And we did. The counts improved, but not enough to warrant continuing it past this point. Caused a very difficult decision to make, but we had to bite the bullet.
I'm delighted. I'm ecstatic. I am so happy I could get up and dance. I just can't. Oh, I really am.
Not really depressed at the show. I'm the company splitting up, yes. That I think is a loss to me personally, but not really the show closing. Because it hasn't been that good an experience dance-wise. But I've wasted 8 months out here dancing. I'm doing nothing. Nothing. I'm looking forward to working again.
I've no bad feelings towards anybody. I really don't. It doesn't matter now, it's over. But I don't feel necessarily that I've been really hard done by or anything. It didn't work. Nobody put it in for it to not to work, you know? They wanted it to be a success. I don't have any bad feelings towards anyone.
In a sense, this has been an 8-month holiday for me. I've spent 8 months of my career over here, and really I should have been at work. And I, as you know, I do an act, and it's not been worked here, and this has been the trouble. This is my main concern, really. Yeah, I feel I've been cheated, because I'm used a bit in the show now as part of the show, and I've thrown 8 months of going back to working a summer audience and to having that thrill on the seafront and doing my thing in a theatre or whatever, and I've missed it.
I've no fine, definite plans at this moment. I'm going to stay around for a month or 6 weeks or so, as long as the money holds out, and see if any jobs do come along. But I feel cheated just having had 6 months here. I came, said we were all mentally prepared for a year or 15 months, whatever it was. And I certainly would like to, like Geraldine says, see more of the country, particularly. And
well, financially as well. It's no good to stay in a country just for 6 months. You buy so much, you're just getting yourself settled, and all of a sudden you have to pack your bags and leave again, and you lose by doing that, by always moving.
For the dancers, there is just the last night to look forward to.
Okay. Jeez. Guess what?
What?
No show tonight.
You're joking?
No, they just called up. Bob called up, and then Vicky called up. No show.
They've cancelled, both of them.
Mm-hmm. So last night was our last night?
Mm-hmm. They must have known about it.
Who knew?
Bing. You could tell Anna knew. I mean, look.
How did Anna know?
I don't know.
It stinks, doesn't
but
it?
But look at everybody. It was so obvious. It was Minka was acting strange. They were doing... Herbie knew last night. I mean, let's face it.
Do we have to go into work then? Or what?
Yeah, we still have to go in for the costumes.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
It sucks, doesn't it?
But everybody really knew in their hearts that there really was going to be no show.
Yeah, I think that's true.
Because it's the whole experience.
It sucks.
Oh,
it sucks.
Yeah. Is somebody going to ring them back?
After 4 months of failure, hasty replacement of the Alcazar show is essential. But the stagehands seem as unenthusiastic about the show's closure as they were about its opening. The dancers, however, seem equally enthusiastic about both events.
Shoes, jewelry, gardens, everything, and bring them here in line, and they'll check you out.
Daisy and Jermaine.
That's a very good question. Let's say this. It's the first time I've ever had a kick in the you-know-what. Because I've been in show business since I was 7 years old, and I've fortunately, up until now, had success.
I simply couldn't.
What? Yes, Geraldine's here. Darling, the last night.
We didn't even get to have...
Oh, well, what can we do?
No, I'm quite happy, actually.
I know.
Where'd you begin?
Jane Anne and Beatrice.
Where'd you begin?
Do you want to pay me tonight?
Yes.
I should sit down and put on my makeup.
I'm done.
Well, this is it.
Did they take this?
No, because you have to count them in.
Returning the costumes is a necessary procedure. They were imported for the show, but only for this show. To protect American costumiers, they must now be collected, counted, checked, and destroyed.
Yeah, work it out. Da, 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 da. One.
Control to
four. Singular sensation. Every little step she takes. Da, 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 da. One. Thrilling combination. Every move that she makes, da 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 da.
We're good.
Nobody else will do.
Nothing ventured, nothing gained. And if something came down the road 2 years from now that would be new and stood a chance, we would take another chance. We're in the gambling business. You win some, you lose some. And that's what show business is. You either bring in a blockbuster or you close at the end of 2 weeks.
Now out of work, and with cancelled work permits, the dancers are just part of the flotsam of Las Vegas show business.
It's been unfortunate since the beginning. The show was, like, jinxed for some reason.
Got a soft spot for Burton.
He was
a swamp. You know, it's like when you were a kid, somebody would give you a jerk sweet, and you'd taste it, and it tasted grey at first. And suddenly you got to the middle, and you'd go, bleh. And that is it. We're sick at the end.
I mean, it wasn't our fault the show didn't work.
No.
You know, we did our best. We went out there every night and worked. It wasn't our fault.
Jane Ann stayed on in Las Vegas and is now working at the Frontier Hotel. Geraldine stayed and met and married the advertising manager of the Riviera. Peter and John returned to England.